Hello friends, Satendra here, and in this video, let's design this twisted cup in Creo Parametric. And to design this, I will use surface techniques. So let's get started. Now in case you need the complete surface training or you are looking for the online training classes one-to-one for Creo Parametric anywhere in the world, then share your contact details to my email ID, which is cadxclasses@gmail.com. You can even share your contact number to get a call, and I'll share all the details related to this training. Thank you. Now let's design this part. And for this, first you go to New, go for Part, select the proper part name, uncheck Use Default Template, and say OK. Now from here, you select a proper part template. So I'll go with this. This is my metric template. In your case, you have a variety of options here. You have this option, this one, or this one. You can go any of this. So I'll go with my template. This is my template. I'll say OK. Now I'll start this part with an extruded surface. So I'll go to Extrude, Surface, Define. I'll select the top datum plane. Sketch, normal. I'll switch off all the datums. Now here, first I'll draw a circle somewhere here. The dia of circle is 100, so make it 100. Say OK. Now this height is 125. Say OK. So the first feature is done. Now the second feature, which is this sketch. So switch on the datum plane. Now in case you are not getting these options here, then you just right click on the graphics toolbar, and from here you can select the datum plane display, axis display, and these options will be added here. So you can easily switch off or switch on the datums. Now the next feature, which is the sketch. So go to the sketch. Select the front datum plane, sketch, normal. Switch off the datum plane. Now to create this sketch, I'll go with the thicken technique. So first I will place a sketch point somewhere here, and then I will add a line here. So I'll start from here. I'll go through this sketch point. I will make this line symmetric from the mid. Now I will just dimension it. So this line from here till here, this side, it is 85. Same way from this end to this end, this side also it is 85. Once this is done, go to thicken, single, circular, and then you select this line. Now the thickness is this gap, which is 10. So make it 10, and one-sided it will be 5. Now just close it. Now this dimension, make it strong. And then you add one more dimension, which is from here till here. This is 20. Once this is done, select this line, right click, go for properties, and make it center line. Apply, close. Now you go for offset. Select this line, hold the shift key, and try to select the entire loop. Now the offset value is 10. So make it 10 and say OK. Now add one more dimension, which is this offset dimension, which is 10, and say OK. So the sketch is done. Now this sketch, I'm going to wrap it on this surface. So for this, go to editing, go to wrap. Now here you have two similar options, wrap and warp. So carefully you select wrap. Now first you select this sketch, then automatically it detects the destination. Just flip it this side and say OK. So, you have two similar options here to get this kind of result. One is wrap, another one is project. So, don't go for project. If you go for wrap, it gives 1:1 result even after placing the sketch on this surface. So, go with wrap. Next thing I will do here is I will trim this surface using these curves. So, for that, go to trim. First, you select this surface and then trimming object. So, trimming object, carefully select it. Move your cursor here, right click and select this outer curve. Arrow inwards, say OK. One more time trim, select this quilt first and then trimming object, this time you go for this inner curve, right click, select it. This time arrow direction should be outwards, so flip it and say OK. Control D. Now you select this quilt and go for thicken. Thicken inside, thickness is 4. And say OK. Now for time being, I'll just hide the wrap. Now this particular feature, I'm going to pattern it. So for that, you first select the entire geometry like this, or you can go with one by one, select this, hold the control key, then select this, this. So like this also, you can select the entire geometry. But I am using Creo 10 here, so I can easily select it using boundary selection. So I will select it like this. I don't have pattern highlighted, but if you go inside, you have geometry pattern. Select it, switch on your center axis. In case if you don't have the center axis, then in that case, you just select right plane, hold the control key, select top plane, and go for center axis. Same way. Right plane, hold the control key, front plane and go for center axis. And then you go for top plane, hold the control key and front plane and go for center axis. You will get all three center axis one by one. So once that is done, select the geometry, go for geometry pattern, go for axis pattern and select the vertical center axis. Go for 360 degree. Number of items must be 11 as per these dimensions. Radial distance, you make it 0 and say OK. So, as per your system configuration, it will take some time. So, now you got the feature pattern. Now, switch on your datum plane. One more time, you go for extrude. Select the top datum plane, normal. Go for reference. Select this outer reference and inner reference. Draw the circle from this center till here, from this center till here. Say OK. Now this one, you make it to next. And say OK. Control D. Switch off the datum plane. Now the next feature, which is a revolve feature. So I'll go to revolve. I'll go for define. I'll select the front datum plane. I'll say sketch normal. Now here I will draw the rough sketch first. Starting from here, I'll go this side and this side. And then I will place a datum center line somewhere here. Now the dimension, so this dimension is 75. Then you have this gap from here till here, this is 4. And then you have this angle 135 degree. So make it 135, that's it. Now just say OK. Now here you go for thicken sketch. And say OK. Control D. So all the base features are done. Now the draft features. So go for round. Select this edge. Take the radius as 2. Hold the control key. Select this edge. And select this edge. Say OK. Control D. One more time round. This time you select this edge. Make the radius as 6. Hold the control key. Select this edge. And then you select this edge. Say OK. Control D. Then the last round, which is on the top somewhere here. This is also radius 6. So hold the control key, select this edge. Say OK. Control D. And your part is done. Now, in case if you are getting any error while designing this part, then keep your part accuracy high, because this is a surface design, so accuracy must be high to get the proper result. So go to prepare, model properties, and here you have accuracy. Change, select absolute, and keep your accuracy high. So you will get the correct result. So that's it from this video. So this was the twisted cup using surface technique in Creo Parametric, and I hope this video will be helpful. Now you can like the video and subscribe the channel to support the channel, and I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.